باب المدينة وحامي نبينا، باب المدينة وحامي نبينا. علي منهج علي تلهج باسمك املاك السماء، علي صالة وعلي جالة علي بتار ودماء، علي سجدة على خدة للعلي دمعه ما، علي غيرة وعلي غيرة من كفول فاطمة.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف خلقه المصطفى محمد. وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحبه المنتجبين ومن اتبعوهم بإحسان إلى قيام يوم الدين. الإخوة العلماء الأعلام، الأخوات المؤمنات، الإخوة الكرام، السلام عليكم جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. Congratulations for all of us. This happy occasion, the birth of سيد الأوصياء وإمام المتقين وأبي الحسن والحسين علي بن أبي طالب سلام الله عليه. I expect more loud salawat when I mention the name of Ali. Because we are celebrating the birth of Imam Ali. Claim that we are a lover of Imam Ali. I don't know why they put me in this program, because it is for the poem and for joy. And when we come here in front of the audience, we forget ourselves, and we have to try to advise to us. Achieve a goal of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi. But anyhow, I will make it very short. My father has a beautiful poem related to Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi. I just remember one poem of that. He said, قَدْ جِئْتَ فِي زَمَنٍ لَمْ يَفْهَمُوكَ بِهِ وكل جيل يحيل الفهم للآتي. You have arrived, you have came in a society that they couldn't understand you. And each generation transfer this responsibility to understand you to other generations until it reached to us. And still, we cannot understand the reign of Imam Ali. That is for a simple reason. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and I'm sure that you know this hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, Ya Ali, ما عرف الله إلا أنا وأنت، وما عرفني إلا الله وأنت، وما عرفك إلا الله وأنا. Oh Ali, this is a saying of Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. Oh Ali, nobody knows you except nobody knows Allah except me and you. And nobody knows me except Allah and you. And nobody knows you except Allah and me. That is the saying of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So who are we? to understand Amir al-Mu'mineen wa Sayyid al-Muwahideen wa Abi al-Hasan wal-Husayn Ali ibn Abi Talib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Saying of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi, and I will leave you to enjoy the poem. Even this saying of Amir al-Mu'mineen, it will remind us about a fact which we don't want to remember always, but it is our way. Suwayd ibn Ghafla, one of the companions of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi, he came to him and he saw the furniture in the house. And he said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, where is your furniture in the house? There is nothing in the house. And the reply of Amir al-Mu'mineen, which I would like all of us to remember it. Not only to remember it, to act according to that also. Not fully to act, but at least to think of act in the future, inshallah. He said, Ya Suwayd, إِنَّ اللَّبِيبَ لَا يَتَأَثَّثُ فِي دَارِ النَّقْلَةِ وَأَمَامَنَا دَارُ الْمَقَامِ وَقَدْ نَقَلْنَا إِلَيْهَا مَتَاعَنَا وَنَحْنُ مُنْقَلِبُونَ إِلَيْهَا عَنْ قَرِيبٍ. Translation. Ya Suwayd, the smart person doesn't collect the furniture while he is traveling, while he is in a state of traveling. And we are traveling no matter how long we live. In this life, we are traveling. So the wise person, the smart person, doesn't collect the furniture in this life since it is a dar al-naqla. As he said, dar al-naqla, it means the status of transferring. وَأَمَامَنَا دَارُ الْمَقَامَ. And in front of us, we have a real house. The house where we will stay forever. وَقَدْ نَقَلْنَا إِلَيْهَا مَتَاعَنَا. And we transfer all our furniture to that house, the real house. And we will be transferred to this house very soon. So brother and sister, the message of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi is to take it easy for this life. No matter how long we will live, no matter how much we collect, we are leaving it. And we have to prepare our house in the hereafter. One of the other advice of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi to Al-Imam Al-Hasan wal-Imam Al-Husayn, which also, it has to be a lesson to each one of us. Why? Because we claim that we are a lover of Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib salamullahi alayhi. Where is the salat? This is wasiyya. Advice of Amir al-Mu'mineen to Al-Hasan wal-Husayn. And we have to try to follow. أُوصِيكُمَا بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ. Amir al-Mu'mineen give advice to Imam Hasan al-Husayn. أُوصِيكُمَا بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ. Imam Hasan al-Husayn doesn't need this advice because they are, according to us, Imam Ma'soom. But this advice is to us. And this is the wasiyya of Amir al-Mu'mineen to us. أُوصِيكُمَا بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ. وَأَلَّا تَبْغِيَا الدُّنْيَا وَإِنْ بَغَدْكُمَا. And don't try to run after this life, to achieve goals of this life. Even if dunya, if this dunya try to capture you, don't try to follow this dunya. وَلَا تَأْسَفَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ مِنْهَا زَوَى عَنْكُمَا. Don't be sorry for anything you lost in this life. It's mean the message, the bottom line of this message, that we have to take it easy for this life. We have to prepare ourselves for the hereafter. وَقُولَا لِلْحَقِّ. Whatever you are saying, you have to have one goal, and that is the justice. وَقُولَا لِلْحَقِّ. وَعْمَلَا لِلْأَجْرِ. Whatever you are doing, have this work, have this job, give you a reward, give you ajr. And that's mean, if he doesn't care about this dunya, what's the meaning of this ajr here? It's mean the day after, the hereafter, the ajr, the reward which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us. Any action we have to take in this life, first we have to think what reward we are gaining in the hereafter. Waquna, this is a great message to all of us. We need it, especially in this life, especially in this time. Waquna lil-zalimi khasma walil-mazlumi awna, and be supporter to those people have been under zulm, under injustice, and be enemy to those who apply the injustice to the others. Dear brother and sister, this is few lessons, very little, less than drop in the ocean of the advice of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi. We try to leave this conference with something which can make our life to be better. Inshallah, we will gain more reward in the hereafter because we remember Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi, and we have to remember that just to remember Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi itself, it is ibadah. It is worship. We are here mentioning Amir al-Mu'mineen. We are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because we remember al-Imam Ali.
Mubarak
for all of us. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.